Good morning and good afternoon, everyone, and thank you for joining us today. My name is Nina, Communication Executive with Syncfusion. Today, we are talking about something exciting, the Syncfusion Toolkit for .NET MAUI. If you're a developer, you probably know how tricky it can be to build apps that work smoothly across different platforms like iOS, Android, and Windows. Well, this toolkit is here to make that a whole lot easier. It's free, open source, and packed with tools to help you create amazing apps from just one codebase. In this interview, we will chat with the product manager, Mr. Vishnu Menon, to learn how this toolkit came to be, what makes it stand out, and how you can start using it in your own projects. So thank you so much again, Mr. Vishnu, for taking your time to be with us. You are welcome.
Hi, all. I am Vishnu Menon, one of the product managers at Syncfusion. I have been with Syncfusion since last 6+ years. Today, I'm very excited to share some insights regarding Syncfusion's MAUI toolkit.
Well, thank you so much, Mr. Vishnu, for that amazing introduction. So let us jump straight into the key questions. What is the Syncfusion toolkit for .NET MAUI and what are its benefits?
So when we talk about what is Syncfusion's toolkit for .NET MAUI, it's nothing but an open source collection of high performance UI controls. These controls are designed to enhance cross-platform app development for iOS, Android, macOS, and Windows using a single code base. And these controls include controls for data visualization like charts, for navigation's tab view, layouts, buttons, notifications, and more. What all of these controls does, they simplify common UI tasks and ensuring a native experience across platforms. When we talk about the benefits of this, they raise performance. These controls are performance optimized. We have provided customization, allowing tailoring of controls for specific app needs. There is cross-platform consistency, enabling development for multiple platforms with one code base, and community support. It's open source nature, cross collaboration and innovation.
Oh, thank you. So we know that there was a collaboration between Syncfusion and Microsoft. Can you tell us about Syncfusion's collaboration with Microsoft on the .NET MAUI and how it came about and what its contribution is? And also, how has this collaboration influenced the development and features of the .NET MAUI toolkit?
Syncfusion's collaboration with Microsoft on .NET MAUI stems from a mutual interest in advancing the framework as a leading solution for cross-platform development. This collaboration came due to the shared expertise between Syncfusion and Microsoft in the .NET MAUI framework. When we talk about the contribution done by Syncfusion, there are basically two categories. One is .NET MAUI toolkit, and other one is working on the .NET MAUI framework repository. So what we do is that we address framework issues, we submit pull requests to improve .NET MAUI. We have been creating PRs, and which resulted in almost 65% of all community PRs created by engineers in the repository for last 6 months. Almost 250 PRs were merged. 100 plus PRs are still in review state. We have been resolving priority items at the earliest, and which provides a quick turnaround time. We have also worked on testing related a lot. When we talk about test automation, we have migrated UI tests from Xamarin UI tests to APM, platform ignore. Test cases were done, converting Xamarin specific unit tests to device tests. We have also improved CI, fixed flaky tests. Feature coverage testing, that's something very important, and we have started recently working on that. And we completed almost two controls, slider and collection view, and we'll be working on other controls in nearby future. And recently, we have started working on triaging the issues daily. Any regression comes, it's taken into first consideration. And we are also planning for reviewing community PRs as a first level review from our end, and then moving it to Microsoft Teams side. And when we talk about the toolkit, we are providing free open source UI controls via the toolkit, releasing almost 24 controls, incorporating community feedback for ongoing improvements, and delivering production-ready controls compatible with latest .NET MAUI update.
Wow, that is so amazing. And now just for clarification purposes, what is the difference between the Syncfusion Toolkit for .NET MAUI and the licensed .NET MAUI controls offered by Syncfusion?
As I talked about, the Syncfusion Toolkit for .NET MAUI is a free and open source 24 essential UI control focus. And these are free to use without any license cost. In contrast to Syncfusion's usual .NET MAUI controls are a part of the commercial offering, which provides a broader, more advanced suite, like data grid is there, list view, scheduler are all there, with additional features and dedicated support, which is tailored for enterprise level needs.
Right. So where can developers find documentation and examples for using Syncfusion Toolkit for .NET MAUI? And what are some of the most useful learning resources available?
When we talk about documentation, developers can access detailed documentation, examples, and API reference in Syncfusion website itself. We have a landing page for that. Let me showcase that for you by sharing my screen. Yeah. I hope my screen is visible. So we have the landing page, syncfusion.com/net-maui-toolkit. This is one of the landing pages which I mentioned. If you check in the first itself, is that we have a link here. If you click that, it takes us to the blog. It's showcasing our contribution in .NET MAUI with Microsoft. And if you scroll down, you will see what happens when Syncfusion and .NET MAUI collaborates, cross-platform compatibility, high performance. It's all about the controls, and we scroll down a little more, you can see the list of 24 controls that is present here. And if I go to one of this, if I click one of them, we will be navigating to that particular control, and it gives an overview, like what it does, what this controls does, and what are the types are there. For example, in charts, there are different types of circular charts are there, and you can see all of the details is here. So when I am developing or when I'm trying circular charts for the first time, I can come to this landing page and learn about and get an overview of how things works and what all things are happening. And when this is the landing page, beyond this, we have a GitHub repository for the .NET MAUI toolkit. It's open source. Anyone can check it out. If you go inside this repository, inside this MAUI samples, there is an app called Gallery. So I have cloned this repository in my local machine. Let me showcase that for you. Just one second. Yeah. So I have cloned it and have run this app in my machine. And when you run that app, it's showcase a sample app for you. So this is the sample browser demo. Yeah. So if you click this one, for example, this lists all of the controls here, and if you click one of them, so if example I'm clicking the Cartesian chart here, it lists all of the different types of charts, the axis support, the legend support, everything is there. So when I'm developing, if I need like which sort of chart should I use, or what sort of samples is needed to check which data is suitable for a chart, and different types of charts are there. So everything is here showcased for you at a sample level. So that's the GitHub repository and the browser sample for you. And beyond this, we have online documentation that is there. I will switch to that. Just one second. Yeah. So this is online documentation for all of the products for Syncfusion, which is help.syncfusion.com. Within this mobile, if you go to .NET MAUI toolkit, you will be introduced to something like this, a page, and you can see all of the controls that has been open source. And if you click any one of them, for example, I will go to circular chart again, and if I click the overview, there is getting started is there, pie chart, different type of charts, the code samples, everything is there. When you're developing, if you feel like anything you need, any APIs that you need to check, or we are not sure what's happening with that, you can come into this website and see what's happening here. Other than this, Nina, we have community forums are there. Also, we have YouTube tutorials for you to learn. Okay.
All right.
I hope it's clear.
It's very clear, Mr. Vishnu. Thank you so much for that beautiful illustration. So what can we expect in terms of future updates and new features for the Syncfusion Toolkit for .NET MAUI?
So when we talk about future updates, in the perspective of .NET MAUI Toolkit, we have plans for new controls, additional controls based on community feedback. We will be releasing them. We are currently working on performance enhancements on those controls. When we talk about the other work, which I mentioned, working on the repository, we will be continuously working on bug fixes. We will be proposing new enhancements. We'll be working on test cases, like improving the test automation. As I mentioned, the control-based feature matrix testing, which is based on different controls. We will be working on those tests for different set of controls, and we will be aligning those updates with every .NET MAUI releases. And Syncfusion's commitment to community-driven development suggests consistent improvements.
Okay. Thank you for that, Mr. Vishnu. So how can developers install the Syncfusion Toolkit in their .NET MAUI projects? Can you explain the main steps to integrate the toolkit and share some best practices or common issues to watch for?
So when we install, how to install Syncfusion MAUI Toolkit in a project, it's very simple, very basic. I will showcase you. And when we talk about some best practice and common issues, there isn't much, but you have to ensure that the Syncfusion's toolkit and .NET MAUI versions are aligned, and you have to ensure that Syncfusion's toolkit is initialized properly in myprogram.cs. That's the two cases that happens very rarely. So let me share my screen, create a simple basic app, and show you how you can install. You can try this also from your end, Nina. So just let me create a new project here. The .NET MAUI app, documents, samples. For now, I am just naming it as MAUI app 1, and then create a project. So by the time the project is created, I will come back to here. So you have to come, we came back to the GitHub repository for the MAUI toolkit. And if you scroll down, we have already given all of the instruction on how to install the toolkit. So this is the instruction. First, you have to copy this single line. And then I will be going back to the project application, which we have created just now. And then right clicking, open integrated terminal, and then pasting this one. So that's it. We have installed the toolkit in the new project, which we have created. Now we're going back. Now we have to configure the Syncfusion toolkit. For this, in myprogram.cs, we have to copy this line of code. So we have to go to myprogram.cs and then paste this. Okay, some error is here. Okay, yeah, you have to use the using namespace here. That's how it will work. Yep, it's done. So now what we have to do is this is done. Like basically we have installed the toolkit in my new project, but we have the usage example here. For this one, what we will be doing, we will be copying the mainpage.xaml here. So I will copy this one. And then the class needs to change, which the class will be the name of the app which we have created. Also the model. So change that one. Okay. This is done in the main page.xaml.cs. There will be some unwanted code that I will remove for now. Okay, this is done. Now, if you scroll down, they are asking us to create a person class as a data point. So I will copy this code, right click here, new file, class, person, and then paste this one. So this is done. Now, they asked us to create a view model class, so I will be doing that also. New file, class, view model, and then paste this one here. So I guess that's it. So let me try running this one. Maybe running it back. Let's hope this one builds without any failure. Yep, it seems to be working. Okay, it has completed. Let it open once. See, Nina, I think it took 2 minutes for creating the application and install the toolkit. And here is a simple chart app that you can run in your any of your cross-platform application like Android, iOS, whichever app you're using. It's very simple and you can try it too, Nina.
All right, thank you so much, Mr. Vishnu, for that beautiful illustration and with clear steps to follow. And I hope I'm going to do that, and I will let you know about that. So, well, that's all the time we have for today. Thank you, Mr. Vishnu, for sharing valuable insights into the Syncfusion Toolkit for .NET MAUI and its impact on cross-platform development. So we've covered a lot about the Syncfusion Toolkit for .NET MAUI, from its collaboration with Microsoft, to some real-world ways it can level up your app development. And a big thank you to our viewers for joining us today. We appreciate your time and interest. If you're curious to try it out, as Mr. Vishnu mentioned, be sure to check out our Syncfusion website for guides, examples, and more. Thank you so much again for joining us. Until next time, bye.